Hello everyone, thanks for watching this video. So in this video, today we are going to understand how to delete the middle element of a even singly linked list. Okay, so first thing is that we have to delete the middle element. Okay, and the second thing is that the singly linked list that we are receiving from the user is a even singly linked list. Even singly linked list means it has total even number of node, means 2 node, 4 node, 6 node, 8 node, likewise. Okay, so in that list of even singly linked list, we have to find the middle element, and we know we have total 2 middle element in any of the middle thing. Okay, suppose that you have a singly linked list having size is 8. Okay, so 3 plus 3 is 6, and the rest middle 2 element is, we will be having total 2 middle element. Okay, means 4th position and 5th position. Likewise, if you see here, we will be having one singly linked list something like that, which has total 6 node. Okay, and our responsibility is to delete the middle element, and we know that in any of the even thing, we will be having 2 middle element. Okay, so for this one, if you see, 6 means 3 plus 3, so 2 plus 2 4 plus 2 6, so 38 and 48 is our middle element, and our responsibility is to delete this one. Okay, to find the middle element and all those things, I already covered this into the program number 7 in very briefly. Okay, so probably you need to watch this program before jumping to the 14th. Okay, 14th number of program. Okay, so we are good now. We understood the question that we have to delete the middle element from a singly linked list, and any of the middle thing, we will be having 2 middle element, and our responsibility is to delete it. So in order to delete the middle element, we have to perform some set of tasks that we are going to document it here. First task is create the singly linked list as always. Okay. Second task is to load the data into singly linked list. Okay, and third task is to link the node. Okay, fourth task is to display the singly linked list. Just to make sure that we created singly linked list correctly, loaded the data and made a connection also perfect. So fifth number is, after displaying the data, we have to find the, means get the size, since on the basis of size only we will be able to understand that this singly linked list is even singly linked list or odd singly linked list. Okay, after that we have to identify the index from where, index means middle index, middle from where we are going to delete the middle element. Identify the middle index from where we are going to delete the middle element, or going to delete the middle element. Okay, good. After doing this, seventh task is to, once we identify, now we have to delete the middle node. Okay, after that we have to display the singly linked list again, just to make sure that node got deleted successfully. Okay, so this total 8 tasks we are going to perform in order to delete the node from a even singly linked list. Okay, so first task is to create the singly linked list, and for that we know we will be having private static inner class called list node, where we will be having two variable declared, Okay, one is the data, which is integer type, since I am creating the linked list is integer type only, integer single linked list. Second one is the reference of the next node, which basically we are calling as a next. Okay, done. After declaring the variable, our responsibility is to initialize, and for that we are going to use constructor. Okay, so for that constructor, okay, and here we are going to pass data as an argument. Good. Now this dot data equal to data, okay, this dot next equal to null, since by default the reference of the next node is null until unless we have to make a connection. So we are good with the first task. Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, eighth is we are going to perform from client side. Okay, so for that we are keeping all those things into the main method. Good. Now load the data. In order to load the data, we have to create the node and we have to pass the data. So first equal to new list node, and the data as per our this one 18 to 68. Okay, so 18. Good. This one is 28 38 48 58 68, means total 6 node. First is also called as a head, so this one is head, this one is second node, this one is third node, this one is fourth node, this one is fifth node, this one is sixth node. So we get a total 6 node. After that we have to link the node, and we know how to link, means head dot next equal to first, sorry, head dot next equal to, means first node I am connecting to second node, and second dot next I am connecting to third node, and third dot next I am connecting to fourth node, and fourth dot next I am connecting to fifth node, and fifth dot next I am connecting to sixth node. Good. So we made a connection of all the 6 nodes. Good till now. Now our responsibility is to check whether really everything happened correctly or not. For that we are going to write a logic to display. Inside the display we are going to pass linked list as a argument that we traverse from first node to last node. So accordingly we are going to create the display method here. Right? Good. So we are receiving list node as, I mean linked list as a argument, and that we are securing into the current local variable. And we know how to display. While display we are going to get the help from while loop. We are going to travel from one node to another node, means one node to last node, and last node means we know the reference of the last node is null. So we are going to check, please let me move only till not null only. Okay, so for that we are going to print the data. So current dot data, say the data, actually we are interested to print the data only. Okay, so here we are good now. This is the one separator between one node to another node, and this println I don't want to print into the next line. I want linked list to be into the same line. Okay, good. So we have printed the data of the one node that we received. Now our responsibility is to do the movement, means go from one node to another node. Okay, so that is good now. As soon as I am coming out of this loop, I am just keeping SOP here just to make sure that we reach the last node. Okay, good. Now right click, run as Java application. If you see here, we are able to get the data 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 9. I mean, we are able to get the sync list, linked list, whatever we created here perfectly. Okay, so we are good till fourth task. Now fifth task is to get the size. In order to get the size, we have to create the size. Okay, good. So let's create the method called size, and here we are passing linked list as an argument. Good. So this is our user input, and we have to secure into the variable name called current. Okay, good. Now and we are going to traverse from one node to another node through the help of while loop, and we are going to traverse till not null only, since null means the last index, last node equal to null. Okay, now we are going to traverse. So current equal to current dot next. This is going to help you to traverse from one node to another node. But I also want to count that how many times I have traveled, means how many times movement happened from one node to another node till I am reaching to last node, means tail, from head to tail. So for that, we are keeping here one counter variable. Okay, this will have the all the detail of movement. Okay, so int counter equal to 0. Okay, so as soon as this while loop ends, so this counter is able to get the all the movement. So what I am doing is, so basically this becomes the size. So as soon as I am coming out of the while loop, I am returning this counter variable, which is directly as a our size only, which is integer type, return type. Good. Now since I am returning here, so I have to see, I have to get the size only, size. Okay, and I have to print it here also. Okay, size of singly linked list is, okay, now right click, run as Java application. If you see, size is 6, means 2, 4, 6, which is correct. Now we got the size of the singly linked list. Okay, now our next task is identify the middle index from where we are going to delete. Okay, middle index. So probably you can write one more step here, identify the singly linked list is even. Okay, then 7, get the middle index from singly linked list. Since we already identified this even, then we have to get the index. Okay, now this one is 8 and this one is the 9. Okay, which is simplified now. Good. Now identify the single linked list is even or not. See, this is returning the size. So in that condition, I am just going to keep size is divisible by 2. Then I can say that single linked list is even. Okay. Right. If single linked list is even, then probably we need to get the index. Okay. So what I will do is, let's have one int index equal to size divided by 2. Okay. This will give you the index. I will tell you, see, as per the even single linked list or anything even, we know that we will be having two middle element value. But here I am taking as a one. I will tell you why. Actually, indirectly it is two only, but visibility is one only. Okay. So what I will do is, let's have one for loop which start from 1, means I will tell you, and it should move till, see, middle element have two middle element, any of the middle thing we will have in two middle element. That's the reason I am just running this for loop 2 times, 1 and 2 times. Now question is, why I am running because of just to delete. So here we are going to write a logic to delete, and here we are passing two arguments. First argument is the linked list and the second argument is index. Okay, so identify the single linked list is even 6, identify the middle index, this should go here, and delete we are doing here. Okay. Good. Now accordingly we are going to create a method here. Okay. Good. So we are receiving two user argument. Okay. First one is the our singly linked list, and the second one is the middle element index, and we are going to secure both of them saying that this linked list, I am saying that this is the previous. Okay, and this index is nothing but what to say, position. Okay. Now with the help of while loop, I am going to traverse from one node to another node. Once I will reach this position, now our task is to start deleting. So for moment I am going to use the while loop, and I am going to move one node to another node dot previous dot previous dot next. Okay. So while doing the moment, now question is, how many times I have to move? Okay, how many times I have to move? So I have to move till index minus 1. As I already told you, if you want to delete the 6th index, you have to focus on your 5th index. If you want to delete the 8th index, you have to focus on the 7th index. That's the reason index minus 1. And I am doing moment, I am having one counter also, counter, counter plus plus. So counter plus plus. Okay, this counter will help me to get the moment index, how many times moment happens. So for that int, counter equal to 1, since head is already there. Okay. So index minus 1 until counter is less than this one, index minus 1. So this while loop will help you to do the movement. If you are not understanding this delete logic, you have to go through the previous program where I have briefly explained this delete logic. Okay, good. Now as soon as I am coming out of this loop, I will be having the value that we are going to delete just before one node. I understood that confusion here, just copy this one, okay, and paste it here. Okay, so as soon as I am coming out of this loop, our task is to delete the middle element. So middle element is 38 and 48, right? Our task is to delete the 38 and 48. As I told you, if you want to delete any element, means 8th position, you have to concentrate on 7th position. So I want to delete the first 3rd position, I am concentrating on 2nd position. So if you print the previous dot data, it is means this you have previous dot data, it has how many, what is the value, it has value as 28. Okay, comment it. Now run this one, you will get to know what I am trying to do here. 28, you see, right? 28. Why 2 times 28? Because of that, in main program I am calling 2 times. See here, that's the reason. Okay, good, no problem. Fine. Now our task, this is 28, we got to know, right? Fine. Now what we will do is, we will create one local variable, and inside the local variable, I mean inside this reference, what we will do is, we will be moving one step ahead, okay, saying that previous dot next, okay, and this you can say as a current. Okay, good. So this value means, if you print it here, basically I just want to replace the value. So I want to delete this 38. So what I will do is, this 28 I will replace with this 48. That's what I am trying to do it here. Okay, so this has 28. Now current dot next, I mean previous dot next, this should have how much? 38. Okay, now I got 28, now I got 38, now I want 48 also. If you want to print it, you can print it also here. Current dot data. Okay, now right click, Java application. You see 38. Got. Now we need 48 also. How I will get? Current dot next. If I will move this step one step ahead. Okay, current dot next. Okay, so this will give you the 48. Okay, now what I will do is, previous dot next, where is the previous dot next? This 38 I want to delete, right? So 38 I am replacing to 48. If you want to check, current dot next means this will give you the 48 only. So replacement done. Now I don't need this SOP here. Okay, so after doing the replacement, still it has the data hold. So I want to make a null so that GC will access, so that memory goes to the function. Okay, good. Now we are able to delete it. Now right click, run a Java application. Okay, it's not able to see because of that. Why this position? Position here. Position. Okay, delete method. So delete, we have to just copy this one on display method after deleting. So this is our task number 9, same code. Now right click, run as Java. You will be saying that 18, 28, 58, 68. See, 18, 28, 38, and 48 got deleted. Right? Now, still we have one question here. This SOP I don't need. This I don't need. Okay. Now, still one question is that I have passed only one index. How it got deleted two times? Okay. Because of that, I will tell you why. Copy this singly linked list. Okay. Paste it here. This is little logical, but very easy. Okay. Now this is the index value. Okay. In first iteration, I deleted the 38. Right. This is our linked list. I got the index. I want to delete the 38, which got deleted. Right. So copy this one. After deleting, keep it here. So 38 got deleted. Good. Now this is your linked list. Now what you want to delete? 48. Right. Our target is to delete 38, the 48. In this singly linked list, we are going to delete the index 3, which is good. We deleted the 33. After deleting, the linked list becomes something like that. And from here also I want to delete the 48. And if you check the index of 48, it's actually 3 only. That's the reason I just took one index and I have deleted two times with the help of for loop. That's what I have passed only one index with the loop, so it got deleted two times. Got it? So this is the only logical changes we had. Now right click, run as Java application. You see this one. Now let's have one SOP here also saying that after deleting the singly linked list. Okay. After deleting the middle node from singly linked list. Okay, and this one is before. Just have one meaningful message, so there shouldn't be any confusion. Now right click, run as Java application. If you see, after deleting, this one is the singly linked list which has total 6 element, and after deleting, if you see, 38 and 48 got deleted, where 18, 28, 58, 68 are there. So we are good now. Let me summarize you. Okay. So our responsibility is to delete the node from a singly linked list which is even. In order to delete the node from the even singly linked list, our first task is to create the singly linked list. After creating the singly linked list, we have to load the data, which is our second task. We loaded the data. Once data loading done, then we have to make a connection from one node to another node respectively. Once done, then we are going to display the singly linked list, make sure that everything went fine till now. Once display done, then we have to get the size to identify whether singly linked list is even or not. Okay. So we are start identifying here. If it is even, then I want the index. We know that for even thing we will be having two index, but here I am working with the one index only. The reason, as I already told you, with the help of for loop I am deleting at the same position two times, so the linked list got rearranged, so I need not to pass the two argument here. Okay, so after deleting, again I am displaying the singly linked list as per earlier only, and I am getting this expected result, which is correct now. Okay, thanks for watching this video.